जसं की जोगेश्वरीचा हा एक नॉन डेव्हलपमेंट एरिया म्हणून रेकग्नाइज आहे गव्हर्नमेंटच्या पूर्ण टोटल प्लॅनमध्ये, तर गेल्या 25-30 वर्षामध्ये इथे बॉम्बेकडून पब्लिक आली, इथे सेटल झाली. कारण की एक मोस्ट ऑफ सगळा हा जो पट्टा आहे तो एक वर्कर्स क्लासचा पट्टा आहे. म्हणजे जे लोक पूर्वी मिल्समध्ये काम करत होते ते सगळे आज इथे मुंबई सबर्मध्ये येऊन सेटल झालेले आहेत. पण आज ह्याच्यावरती गेले 30 वर्ष ही एवढी मोठी झोपडपट्टी बसली आहे. आणखीन आजचा हा स्लम पूर्ण ऑथोराईज झाल्यासारखा आहे. कारण की इथे BMCचं पाणी येतं, BSES चं इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आहे, सगळ्यांचे 95 अगोदरचे मतदान यादीमध्ये सगळ्यांची नाव आहे. त्याच्यामुळे एक ऑथोराईज्ड एरिया म्हणून आज लोक किंवा नेतेसुद्धा डिक्लेअर करतात की हा सगळा ऑथोराईज एरिया आहे म्हणून. पण तरी सरकारच्या प्लॅनिंगवरती अजूनही हा नॉन डेव्हलपमेंट एरिया म्हणून त्याचं एक शिक्कामोर्तब आहे. तर गेल्या म्हणजे 10-15 वर्षाच्या अगोदर इथे पाण्याची म्हणा किंवा लाईटची म्हणा खूप मोठा प्रॉब्लेम होता. म्हणजे मे बी 2-3 दिवस पाणी नाही यायचं किंवा मग 1-2 दिवस लाईटच नसायची.
जास्त जर असं पाणी असलं, समजा लवकर आलं पाणी, तर 15 मिनिटं भेटतात, नाही तर 15 पण नाही केव्हा केव्हा 10 मिनिटच होतात.
आमच्याकडे 5-5:45 पाणी येत.
हा, लवकर उठून पाणी
भरायला लागतं आम्हाला.
किती तास असतं?
अगदी 2-2.5 तास म्हणजे म्हटलं तरी चालेल. 7:45-8 पाणी जात.
7:45 मग दिवसभराच्या कामांना पुरेल एवढं पाणी भरायला,
म्हणजे काय लोकांना पुरतं काय लोकांना कमी पडत, मग काहीतरी युज करतात ना असं.
मग तुमच्या घरी तुमचा नळ आहे का बाहेर?
नाही, आमचा स्वतःचा नळ आहे. आमच्या चाळीत काय चाळ कमिटींचे नळ आहे असे.
म्हणजे पाणी आणायची बायकांना सुविधा असं झालेलं आहे, तकलीफ हटले. म्हणजे कसं नवीन नगरला नवीन नगरला लांब पडतो, तिथनं हंडा एक हंडा आणायला 1 घंटा लागत होता. आता बायकांना एवढी सुविधा झालेली आहे की हे पाण्यापासून प्रत्येकांची गल्लीमध्ये वॉशिंग प्लस आहे. वॉशिंग प्लसवर आता एवढं तकलीफ नाही बायकांना की पाणी भरून पडसे जेवणं बाणं पोरांना शाळेतलं आणणं तकलीफ बाजू झालेलं आहे.
Yeah, I certainly think water is so basic for any community, you know, any human community. And we know that clean water is the very basis of the revolution in public health in the West in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, so much so that it's widely, I think, accepted that the road to general public health in the West was not necessarily the great scientific discoveries and so on, but simply the provision of cleaner water and the control of waterborne diseases and so on. I tend to subscribe to that view. So yes, I think there's great potential there, but there's also great potential because, and here I bring in the cultural dimension, water really is seen as perhaps in India more than in other places, as simultaneously need filling or need fulfilling in terms of thirst and so on for the human body and for animals and so on. But it's also seen as cleansing and as purifying. So people will make a very large effort to have a small interaction with water as part of their sense of feeling both cleaner and better and purer.
या शहरामधले जे गँगस्टर, त्यानंतर माफिया लोक जे जुने जे आहेत, ज्यांचा बॅकग्राऊंड म्हणा जे ब्लॅक आहे, एकदम डार्क बॅकग्राऊंड, आणि गँगस्टर माफिया लॉबी जी आहे तीच याच्यामध्ये सक्रिय आहे. आणि टँकर लॉबीमध्ये आज टँकर पुरवणं ते सुद्धा पाहिजे त्या मुमंग्या दाममध्ये ते सोपं काम नाही आहे, येड्यागबड्याचं काम नाही, म्हणजे छोट्या माणसाचं काम नाही. त्याच्यामध्ये एकच आहे की हुक अँड कुक, आम्ही हा टँकर एवढ्याला विकणार आणि तो तुम्हाला घ्यायला लागणार. प्यायचं पाणी ड्रिंकिंग वॉटर कन्स्ट्रक्शनला लाईनला वगैरे पाठवायचं, मग तो जो थोडा कोटा पुरा असा कमी पडत जातो तिथे मग टँकर लॉबी एंटायर करून ती व्यवस्थित अगदी ऍक्टिव्हेट होते.
Informal settlements, you might say from this point of view, could be defined as settlements that have no invisible thing going on, that everything is visible, and how water and food and shelter are constructed is fully available to the gaze. Whereas a wealthy community, a rich community, a middle class community in any Indian city or any Western city has to have at least 50% of its real life hidden from view. And be effective, not only be hidden from you but be effective. But informal communities don't, and in Bombay has a very large variety of, you might call, again to invent a phrase, communities that you might say subsist and survive completely horizontally, that is at the very level or plane on which you see them. That's where they are, and they're connected to others horizontally. There is a whole world of staff and domestic help and so on who don't have access to those things and who live in the stairwells and sort of non-official spaces off those vertical buildings and of course all around them. So it's not even that the heterogeneity is horizontally just adjacent. It's highly interdigitated with the spaces that have the infrastructure. So the presence and absence of working infrastructure is both a matter of a horizontal geography in which some communities have it and some don't, but is also a kind of helical fact about single spaces, vertical for example, in which 50% of the people have it and the other 50, roughly, or 30%, of servants, chauffeurs, drivers, cleaners, domestics, dependents of various kinds, don't have it. And they then are actually denizens of the horizontal or infrastructure-free city, where infrastructure and, let's say, extra structure are the same.
This is the first concrete dam after independence, which is made from the technology pre-cooled concrete. So this is the great achievement for Indian people.
Presently we are supplying water to the Greater Mumbai. Quantity is about 3,200 million liters about. Main sources are Tansa, Vaitarna, Upper Vaitarna and Bhatsa. Total quantity of water will come up to this particular point. This point. Where these four walls are closed and water is diverted with the help of this saddle tunnel to the Bhandup complex.
This plant is working for last 26 years without any disturbance, without any shutdown, major shutdown. And as such, Mumbai's citizens are getting their water supply regularly every day on their scheduled timings. To tackle with the future populations, we are going in for additional schemes. We are going to add Middle Vaitarna, Gargai, Pinjal. All those water will be brought over here at Bhandup complex. And we are going to add more treatment plants in this complex itself. And by 2021, we will be having a capacity of almost 700 million gallons per day supply from Bhandup complex.
I certainly think the state understands that controlling and managing water is its business, or at least partly its business. And the whole controversy over big dams, the constant disputation between states over rivers, all this means the state is in the water business. And when you get down to cities in the municipalities, it's the state so far that by and large takes care of the state of the infrastructure, for better or for worse, so for the supply of water. So I think the state is very far from being in a position to walk away from water in the way that, for example, it may have very little to do with IT, say. Water is too basic to agriculture, water is too basic to elementary democracy, water is too basic to everyday life for the Indian state, which is still very large, very active, and very present.
Our water at source is good. It's treated well at Bhandup, it's monitored well, but it can be contaminated in pipes, it can be contaminated in overhead tanks. There are overhead tanks which have not been cleaned for 20 years, 30 years. And at home, so the poorer the area, the more chances of the water that they get being contaminated. So you keep having these sporadic epidemics coming up.
सर पाण्याची वर तर एक दिवस जर बॉम्बेला पाणी नसेल तर आज बॉम्बेची परिस्थिती काय असेल तुम्हाला तर माहितीच असेल. एक दिवस जर पाणी नसेल तर मुंबईची परिस्थिती काय होते. मग हे सगळं आम्हाला आमचं जे सगळा स्टाफ आहे 24 तास त्यांची ड्युटी चालू असते. त्यांच्यासाठी रात्र आणि दिवस तिन्ही शिफ्ट ठेवलेले आहेत तिथं भांडू कॉम्प्लेक्सला सुद्धा. मग त्यामुळे त्या काय सर्व सेवा म्हणजे अत्यावश्यक सेवेमध्ये येते. वॉटर डिपार्टमेंट आहे एकदम अत्यावश्यक सेवेमध्ये
नसते.
फक्त एक विकली ऑफ मिळतो तोच फक्त आम्हाला. बाकीचं आम्हाला मग आमची सेवा करायचं आणि एक सेवा म्हणजे आम्ही एक पुण्य कार्य केल्यासारखंच आम्ही त्या प्रकारेच करतो. बाबा एक पाणी देणं एखादा घरी आपल्या माणूस आला की त्याला पाणी देणं एक पुण्य आहे. त्याप्रमाणे आम्ही लोकांची सेवा होते ह्या प्रकारेच आम्ही कामं करत असतो.
अर्लियर वॉटर मॅनेजमेंट वॉज इन पब्लिक रिया. पीपल न्यू द इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ वॉटर अँड दे सॉ टू इट दॅट दे हॅड वॉटर इवन इन वर्स्ट ऑफ ड्राउट्स. टुडे इट इज अ थर्ड पर्सन कॉल्ड गव्हर्नमेंट विच इज सपोज टू गिव्ह अस वॉटर.
तर इथे एवढा जरा फ्लो जातो. ही जमीन आहे ह्याच्यात जर आपण काही स्क्वेअर असे हे मारले तर ते पाणी तिकडे झिरपू शकते. आता हा नाळा बघितलात आपण पाणी येते पण तिकडे जर त्याला हे केल्या कुंड्या सिस्टीम केल्या आणि त्याच्यामध्ये ते पाणी जर स्टॉक व्हायला लागलं तर इकडची लोक ते पाणी चांगलं स्वच्छ पिऊ शकतात. प्लस ते पाणी जमिनीत जाऊ शकते. आता ते चाललं खऱ्या पाण्यात मिळणार. परत समुद्रातली ह्याची ओटी आणि भरती येईल. त्या ओटी भरतीमुळे ते पाणी मिक्सिंग होऊन सगळं ते खपून जाते.
One of the things is the reason for this flood. You know, you had the Mithi River, okay, and a natural way by which excess water would go into the sea. Now, once the Bandra Kurla complex came up, they have blocked certain sections. The intensity of flooding is increasing on one hand, and on the other hand, we've blocked that area because of the new construction, and therefore the floods come out on the street. Together with it, of course, there's been such concretization. So all natural areas by which water could go in are disappearing.
There's a lot of thought and a lot of work that went into restoring this river called Mithi River. The word Mithi in Indian terms means sweet. That water course used to carry sweet water and hence it was called Mithi. It's an important thing to note. In an island, स्वीट वॉटर इज ऑलवेज अ प्रेशियस थिंग. पीपल रिवर्ड दॅट रिवर, देन दे फॉरगॉट इट ॲज अ रिवर, दे मेड इट इन टू अ गटर.
फ्लडचं कसं झालं होतं की मागच्या वेळी जेव्हा 23 जुलैला हा पाऊस पडला होता तेव्हा जसा चेरापुंजीचा पण रेकॉर्ड तोडणारा तो पाऊस होता आणि तो काल मुंबईमध्ये पडला होता. म्हणजे हा तसा या पूर्ण एरियाला तसा काही मोठा फटका पडला नव्हता म्हणजे पावसाच्या ह्याचा, पण हा जो रस्ता जातो त्याच्या खालच्या साईडला जो आहे त्याच्यामध्ये जवळजवळ घरं पूर्णतः डुबली होती पाण्यामध्ये.
Worldwide, the issue of privatization is becoming dysfunctional because there is no transparency in the whole process, and it's all done in the name of equity and proper access. And what happens is that the process of privatization is not transparent. The capacity of the municipal administration to arbitrate the interests of different people is not done strongly. It is always done in the favor of the provider with whom they might have some informal handshakes. See, there's a lot of opaqueness in all these things. So on one hand, there's a lot of trepidation about it. On the other hand, there's complete lack of capacity in our public institutions at the moment. So you despair about that. So it's like between the devil and the deep sea, you don't know which one's better.
Yani dila te kai baraj hai pan amhala garibanna patne evda dila paijil asa hai mhanje private pan yetat tumhi ata amhala ek khuli ghar dilat tumhi 2000 3000 maintenance lavla ta amhala parvadaycha nahi te parvadel ka garibanla kai sagles paise wale nahi hai kai lokanna nokrya nahi hai konala kai nahi hai asa hai te प्रायव्हेट वाल्यांनी जरी आम्हाला काय करून दिलं ना तरी आम्हाला बरं वाटेल, पण आम्हाला कमीत कमी सोयी झाल्या हे झालं पाहिजे, स्वस्त झालं पाहिजे.
In Bombay, where they have started privatization on a pilot basis in the K East ward, they've chosen the ward which is a rich ward. Now I would say if you're going to do a pilot study and if you're really doing it out of concern and seriousness, you would at least choose an average ward. This is the ward which is providing, one of the 3-4 wards which provides income to the BMC to help other wards. It earns because it's got, you know, the commercial rates of water are high, and that ward has more commercial outlets. So it makes about 55 crores, yeah, and they've chosen that as in that area. But what's, yeah, they build up this whole premise of a water crisis, which is true, okay, and then they say, okay, BMC is not able to manage it efficiently, so now it should be the get in the private company. And there's been a lot of push by the center for this. The local BMC doesn't even want it, and they have no say in it. There is no regulator in the city or in the country on how is the whole thing going to be managed, whether the poor are going to be further marginalized, you know, or in are the people who can pay only the ones who are going to get the benefit of this. But perhaps because it's a rich ward, they'll be able to have a very good demonstration effect.
Basically, what they say that Mumbai will be the largest city is they're talking about the metropolitan region. And one of the challenges that we are facing as a city today is looking at what is the governance structure that's going to look at the metropolitan region. Those of us who are addressing the issues of equity and want the city to retain its cosmopolitanism, its openness to all kinds of people, are struggling with the reality that the income distributions are getting more and more sort of wide. So on one hand, we know that there's an economic reality that globalization brings in that is like a juggernaut that's very hard to stop. But what do you do with all these other problems? Because if you take Bombay, Pune out of Maharashtra, it's as bad as Bihar and other places. So people are going to come into this city. And it is going to grow. And it's going to have all these things happening to it. So I think the real challenge in all this is, instead of saying, shall we be like Shanghai and shall we be that, it would be terrific if this city said, can we have a new face of globalization which addresses equity? But it's not in the discourse yet.
पंद्रह बीस साल पहले जो परिस्थिति थी उससे तो थोड़ा अच्छा है, पर इतना अच्छा भी नहीं है। अभी भी इसको बहुत अच्छा बनाने की ज़रूरत है, क्योंकि पानी से जो प्रॉब्लम होता है आदमी को, वो सबसे बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है। क्योंकि सबसे पहला चीज़ तो पानी का जो टाइम है यहाँ का, वो बहुत डेंजर है। 12 बजे गरीब आदमी, कोई मिट्टी पे काम करने जाने वाला है, कोई बंदर पे काम करने जाने वाला है, कोई वॉचमैन है, सब इस तरीके के लोग हैं ज़्यादातर। तो वो लोग अपना ड्यूटी करे क्या, वहाँ ड्यूटी से छोड़ के आके पानी भरे, या फिर वो क्या करता है, मजबूरी में आदमी अपना जो बच्चे को स्कूल में पढ़ना चाहिए उसको जिम्मेदारी देता है, बाबा मैं काम पर रहेगा, मैं कमा के लाएगा और तुम पानी भरना। तो बच्चे का भी फ्यूचर ख़राब होता है। सोचने को जाएगा तो बहुत बड़े प्रॉब्लम है अभी भी। तो उससे अगर टाइम बढ़ेगा तो बच्चा अच्छे स्कूल में पढ़ेगा तो अपने देश के लिए कोई अच्छा बन सकता है, दुनिया के लिए अच्छा बन सकता है, कुछ भी बन सकता है।
आमचा प्रश्न आहे की विकास न व्हावा असं काही आमचं म्हणणं नाही आहे, म्हणजे कुठे डेव्हलपमेंट रोकावी असा काही आमचा मुद्दा नाही आहे। पण प्रश्न फक्त आमचं फक्त एवढंच म्हणणं आहे की जो विकास जो होतो आहे तो नॉर्मल लोकांसाठी होत आहे, तर तो नॉर्मल लोकांच्या गतीने व्हायला पाहिजे।
It has long been the case that we've had very advanced both science as regards water purification, but engineering. We're not a society that doesn't know how to make things. So when you add up those two facts, the fact that we fundamentally don't have potable, safe, healthy water is stunning. And to me, continues to stun me, because neither the technology nor the science is very mysterious. And the only other missing piece then would be the money to make the investment. And the Indian government constantly claims that we are now better off economically than ever before. We don't need foreign aid. We don't need development assistance, so we are told. Well, if so, how can we have so many hundreds of thousands of people lacking access to potable water? It's not the technology, it's not the science, it's not the money. Well, that leaves politics and culture, I suppose. Will and habit.
एखादा पाण्या न पाणी न मिळाल्यामुळे माणसाचा मृत्यू झाला तर न्याय कुदर दूर राहिला, त्याच्यावर झालेला तो शेवटचा अन्याय असतो, तो परत न्याय मागायला उभाच राहत नाही उठून।
Thank you. Thank you.